It's been a mixed bag of results for Hamburg since Kazusada snapped their 11-match unbeaten streak back in round 22. However, Hamburg remains nestled in the middle of the pack in the race for European spots for next season in sixth place. And they haven't lost to AOL since last August as they welcomed Schalke. The latest episode of the Schalke soap opera reveals continued off-the-field problems threatening to engulf the club in a crisis. But you have to give first-year coach Frank Neubauer plenty of credit for keeping Schalke from imploding. Hamburg, Schalke, round 25, the Bundesliga begins next. Welcome to the AOL Arena. Round 25 of the German Bundesliga on Fox Sports World gets underway with a good one. Hamburg, Schalke, these teams separated by 1 point as the race for Europe heats up. The final 10 matches, including today's, in the season here in the Bundesliga. Last meeting highlights, round 8, October the 5th, early on, Victor Agami. The Nigerian with a sweet goal. And Schalke would have all they would need on the day. Later in the half, Asamoah leads it for Campos. He picks out Evan Sand, not once, but twice. It was 2-0, and then Asamoah faces it off himself. 3-0, the final score. As Hamburg looked for a season series split today. Here at home, we take a look at the starting 11. Piekenhagen in goal. Uch Falusi's been very good all year long. Lars Jakobsen making only his 7th appearance. We'll keep an eye on him. Mini Matevicchia has 1 goal. He came last week in their 1-1 draw with Stuttgart. He has a league-high 11 assists as well. Starting 11 for Schalke. Victor Agali is suspended from that elbowing incident with Dede in Dortmund a few rounds ago. Thomas Heitner is also unavailable. That makes room for Matte Jan, who's overcome the flu, to get the nod today in the back line. We look at the bottom half, locking horns today. Our referee is Jürgen Arndt, 43 years of age from Cologne, gets the match underway. Hamburg, the home team, in the white and red kits, have the ball first. This should be an outstanding contest when you stop and consider this. Hamburg have lost just once their last 14, while Schalke just one loss in their last 12. Long ball over the top. Out of the reach of Bernardo Romeo, the Argentine. In a decent year, 8 goals, 1 assist, 17 appearances now. He was missing in action for quite some time with that back injury. I'm your host, Alan Hopkins. As always, we thank you for joining us. A live Sunday fixture in the Bundesliga. He finds Asamoah. He's cut down as he charged toward the goal. Asamoah and Bernd Hollerbach, meeting their acquaintances. We look at the Hamburg bench. Takahara, the Japanese international, football of the year in Japan, number 32. And for Schalke, Pedro Rodriguez and Mark Vilmots, a very thin bench for a Schalke team that had to dip into the reserve team to round out their squad today. Frank Rose. So far for Schalke this season. Christian Poulsen looking for Ebba San. Nodded back to Piekenhagen from Tomas Uchtfalusi. Uchtfalusi's put together a great year playing every match so far. Does have 2 goals as well. Plays a good ball to Barber as he nonchalants it. Goes out of play. Asamoah out of contract at the end of the season. Still yet to sign a new one. He goes down again. Does he get the whistle this time? You bet. ...24-year-old Asamoah, the first black man to represent Germany. Good roll off the bench for Rudi Völler's men, the World Cup, Korea, Japan. He's on quite a few teams' wish lists. Under Berlin really would like to land out Samoa. Julius Sauer's vowed to keep him, although no contract has been inked yet. Piekenhagen on the ready. The free kick first of the match from Schalke coming in. And hauled in by Piekenhagen. And Poulsen greets Piekenhagen as we've seen a couple face-to-face encounters already. Colin Benjamin. Long ball taken away. Good win by Nico Jan Hoogma, the captain. Number Sand, look what I found. Asamoah making a good run in front of him. Clearing some space, Sand. Hit it. And slicing to the right the entire time. Masson, Danish international, 4 goals and 1 assist this season in 24 appearances now. Lucy. Goes across midfield. Barbarez, he's off to a sluggish start. See if he can turn it on. Gustavo Varela, no Uruguayan. Good knock. Hans Voldak. Get out to the left. Right above Matillon. Bounces one forward to Varela. Varela, he's pushed down as he tried to make his run forward. Jakobsen, 23-year-old, making just his 7th appearance. Milan Foucault suspended for this match. Jakobsen taking his spot in the back line. 5 minutes of action in the books. Free kick coming in. Not too bad. Oh, it's swatted away. The volley never came. The volley back in. Piekenhagen had to swat away on his line. Here's the replay. Right there. He saw it late, but he saw it in time nonetheless. Schalke enter this match. 3 straight draws. And 11 in the Bundesliga, which is the most. Schalke, extremely tough team to beat. This team has played 35 matches in all comps this year, and they've only lost 6 times. 15 wins, 14 draws, 6 losses. Samoa and Hollerback. Entertaining matchup to watch unfold. Schalke have only lost 4 times in the league. Only Bayern have lost fewer times. Hollerback swilling those hips, eludes Asamoah. Has a little something to say as well. Hoogma. Here's Cardoso, 34-year-old Argentine playmaker. Desperately would like a number 10 in the fold for next season. And they're targeting the playmaker. One name that's popped up in the past week is Liverpool's out of favor, Patrick Berger. Ball over the top, Romeo giving chase. Tomas Valdok cuts it away. Christian Poulsen playing right back today. Showing his versatility. Great ball on the ground. Barbarez, good turn. Barbarez had it poked away from behind. He didn't see Poulsen. Good ball out. Hoogma. Hoogma's been in and out of the doghouse this season. As has most of the Schalke team, truth be told. The team that very nearly has come apart at the seams. Of infighting this year amongst players. Vermont angered just about everyone in the dressing room last week when he said that no one on the team was untouchable. And that if they need to start from scratch, the club should do it. And Avicii, get the first time ball on the throw in. Puma's problems have been well documented. But one of the biggest stories that's come out in the last 2 weeks is Thomas Heintl in trouble with the German authorities for cigarette smuggling. Heintl suspended for this match. Could be in some deep, deep trouble. German authorities broken up a smuggling ring, and Heintl has very much been a part of it. Already arrested some of his, I guess, peers, you could say. Authorities did search his house and came up with some evidence, and now it's going to go to the courts, it appears. Look at this from Frank Roost. Somehow Roost came out with it. Tackle to Barella. Barella edged off the ball. The ball into the space. Barbarez pulls in shoulder to shoulder. And wow, the call goes the other way. Should have been a no call. Kurt Yara gets off the bench for the first time. The protest for the fourth official. Barella, he stays on it. Gets his feet right. The cross in. He's got a man there. Oh, it was a sweet hit volley by Buma. On his right foot as well. Buma hit it well, but couldn't keep it on target. The right foot just as dangerous as the left. I mentioned Asamoah's contract up at the end of the season. Buma, another hot prospect as well. Question will be what club is willing to take on some of his baggage. He's certainly one of the best left wide midfielders in the league. Years ago when Schalke ended up coming up 1 point short to Bayern Munich in the title race, Buma had a breakout season. Hoogma picked Mandevickia out. Buma cuts it back. Right there. Barella making another good run in front. Emerson trying to slip it through. Hoogma again plays it long. Flicked on. Oh, bad touch. Renovicki, can he make him pay? Out to the right. It's a dodgy ball. Knocked away, though, very nicely. Good commence there defensively for Schalke. Colin Benjamin, the back heel. Vicky, the cross in. Schalke, pretty good record away from the arena. 5 wins, 4 draws, 3 losses. The only club better away from home is Bayern Munich. Schalke collected 19 of a possible 36 points. They've truly been road warriors. They're winless in the last 2 away games. Hollerback and Asamoah renew their acquaintances. Asamoah coaxes Hollerback into the giveaway. Schalke, they're trying to capitalize. Sand goes down. Asamoah got a foot in there in front of Hollerback, but only as far as Benjamin. Hamburg have been outstanding at the AOL this season. 8 wins, 2 draws, 1 loss. The only loss came to Bayern Munich back in round 3, late August. Unbeaten in 9 straight sets. Won 3 in a row. Great ball. Roast off his line. Radovicki got off the snide and got his first goal against Stuttgart a week ago. Great result for Hamburg. The Gottlieb Daimler. Ramos was there. He diagnosed the play. Was on it. Very well. Alvarez. Cardoso settles things down. Benjamin. Benjamin. Barberez has played some dodgy balls at best, and Benjamin helped him out once again. Schalke, a very good defensive team. 26 goals allowed. Coming for third with Hertha Berlin, Dortmund, and Bayern. The only two teams with a better defense. And Lausanne comes up lane. What an awkward step. It'll take a little bit more than that to keep him out. We're talking about a man that overcame testicular cancer. Overcome back injuries as well. Slowed last year. Did turn around his form in time to have a pretty productive World Cup. But he hasn't been able to really hit his stride this season. It's Falusi. Hamburg backs dying to play long balls. Percentage of completions pretty low so far. Asamoah caught on the ball. Barberez back to Hollerback. He cuts it. Look at Poulsen. Poulsen regards one of the best midfielders, showing his grit as a right back. Hollerback tried to cut it back, and Poulsen just delivered a forearm shiver. Hollerback likes that. Very physical player. Tell you what, some great matchups on the wings to watch. Asamoah and Hollerback on the near side. Hollerback wins that duel. And on the far side, Buma and Matavicchia. Alvarez. Early ball by Hoogma. Jacobsen. They're not playing it long. Matavicchia. Benjamin in front of him. Matavicchia gets out of the space. Benjamin circles back in. Jabal finds Hoogma again. It's Belusi. He's just tripped up by Sven Vermaats. Junior Vermaats. 15 appearances, 4 goals. While we get a moment, first check of the out-of-town scoreboard, Bielefeld. 1 goal up on Gladbach. Gladbach got their first win. To jumpstart the Ivar Leinen era last week. For Bielefeld at the arm, leading 1-0, back to live action. Varela, that touch got away from him, but he's able to get to it. Matavicchia behind him. Varela stays on it. Varela finally tripped up by Benjamin. Intriguing ball by Matavicchia. No score yet at the AOL. Hamburg, 3 wins, 3 draws, 1 loss in 2003. Samoa. He has matched Uch Falusi that time. As Piekenhagen hasn't missed a match since making the move from Rostock. Two years ago now, he's been the steady number one Hamburg were hoping for. Jacobsen. The team's really using the flanks to attack. It's Samoah to Poulsen. Dane. First season with Schalke. And Hoogland got it forward. Buma splits the defense with that pass. Morella offside. He tries to throttle down to get back onside and does so. Buma started the play. Wants to help it out. He's on the ball now, working on Jakobsen. His cross is swallowed up by Jakobsen. Benjamin caught on the ball. He's not playing too well to start this match. Gets away with a foul. Benjamin. Short, short, long, but only Thomas Waldock is there. And Vicky and Romeo can't combine. And it's time for Poulsen. Throws it up with Barberez in front of him. Asamoah. Circled in behind. Holler back to win it. Asamoah. Double team takes him off the ball. Marcel Maltreats wants to play early. Too early. Romeo called for offside. Good call. Good ball, Buma. Well, I can't do anything with it. Still trying to keep it alive. Benjamin there. Matayan. Buma. Gets it back. Trying to feed Matayan. Took a deflection, but it got there. Matayan. That ball is going to stay in play finally. Almost over the near sideline, or the far sideline, I should say. Schalke throwing. Giveaway. Both teams guilty of unforced errors in the midfield. Right on cue. The ball for it. Cut out. And Avicii outside the left foot ball. Right on the money. Here's a chance. 3-on-1. Stay onside. The pullback. Barberez on his left foot. In the end, the buildup. The height. Not equal. The end product is Barberez. See Romeo offside there. And Barberez, look at everyone getting back in a dark jersey. Most has held his ground. Look at him taking a peek, peering around a defender. No problem at all. Barberez hasn't found the back of the net since round 19. Early February. Holler back. He's not going to get around Asamoah. For a moment, it looked like Holler back was going to get the corner with Asamoah. Had great positioning. And the pace as well to keep up with Holler back. Asamoah just played through those fouls. The whistle finally was blown. Morgan Ost has been a referee since 1990. And the veteran officials in the Bundesliga. Poulsen gets it away. Oh, what a sweet touch by Morella. Back to Sand. Morella gets it back on the 1-2. He's going to return the favor. Cut out by Uchtelusi. Morella still on it. And that was an awkward challenge. Both players down. Hoogma down for Hamburg. He went in on that tackle with Morella. The first touch, just get it out of his reach, and then ouch. But it all started onside. Jakobsen had kept Morella on as well. sweet touch. Ebason returning the favor, and one more look at the tackles. Both players went in 50-50. Huma on his feet. Rudy Pernon, a tough guy. The style is Rudy Assauer. The coat to match. The tie. Gets a yellow card. I guess that's really insult to injury. First card of the match. And not the first card of the season for Varela. That's his fifth. He'll be suspended. He's also been shown the door twice. Two red cards. One a straight red, the other for two bookable offenses. So Varela continues to adjust to the discipline here in the Bundesliga. And adjusted so well. So missed his third match due to suspension next week. Ball shielded out of play. Jacobson disagrees. It'll be a throw-in for the visitors. Jaws back on. Harsh yellow. Both players were going in 50-50. Bruma. Varela tripped up. Good skills to keep it. Poulsen jumping into the attack. Leads Varela. He goes down. Varela back on his feet. Cuts away by Maltreats. He should have a corner kick. Tell you what, lots of contact there with Uchvalusi. And touch away by Maltreats. Keep an eye on Varela. He's really limping right now. So Uchvalusi, left foot clipping up Varela. He's looking up over at the near sideline. Buma, the first corner of the match. It's loose! Bouncing inside the six. Hamburg able to scramble it away. Onside, Poulsen. On the no look. Sweet. Buma dips that shoulder. Looking for a way to get his shot off. Deflected. Buma cutting inside. Getting deflection off of Hugma and Uchvalusi. Took plenty of bite out of it as Matheon is right there, just in case it fell. And back to Frank Rose, he keeps it at his feet. Benjamin puts it back the other way. Baldock. Just able to sort it out. Maltreats. Barbarez. Back to Maltreats. He can't do anything with it. Poulsen the step over. He's going to try to let it go out of play. Poulsen falls on it and he was fouled. Meanwhile, at the Ruhrstadion, Bayern Munich have taken the lead. Bayern Munich with a 13-point lead at the top. Playing without Michael Ballack. Peter Neuer's side just 5 points clear of the relegation zone. Bochum have won just once in the last 26 meetings with Bayern Munich. Hornbook not favoring the home team there. Like a handball, late whistle, finally Asamoah caught. I know that man, that's Wolfgang Wolf. Ex-coach at Wolfsburg. Making the rounds now. So check out any match he can. His time on his hand, his replacement Jürgen Rober. Winning his debut last weekend. Dane Wolf did quite a bit for Wolfsburg, and sad it all came to an end, but the club felt like he wasn't the man to get them to where they needed to go. Lugnaas breaking up this little skirmish. He wants to have a little word with Sven Kamesh and company. Treats didn't like that play. Romero! What a goal! 1-0 Hamburg! Welcome back, Bernardo Romero, his first goal since undergoing back surgery. Off the restart, flicked on by Barbarez, and Romero beats Waldorf. Frank Welsh hoping for the best. Cardoso starts it, one Argentine, and it's capped off by another. Great finish by Romero, his ninth league goal, and Hamburg take the lead just before the half hour mark. Romero's first goal since striking twice against Leverkusen in round 15. Samoa looking to fashion a quick reply on the ground behind Abassan, who lost his footing. Give Barbarez the assist on the sweet flick, his third of the season. Hamburg yet to lose a match when scoring first this season. They've done it 10 times now. And they won 7 of the previous 9 in which they found the back of the net before the opposition. They go along with 2 draws. Bernard's man is just 1 loss in the last 14 coming in. Ball to Jörg Buma. Trying to keep his head as he talks with Jürgen Alst. Hamburg looking to double their advantage. Wonderful free kick opportunity here. Free kick coming in. Hit flat. Ranavicchia giving chase. Ranavicchia, he wins it back. Ranavicchia, great ball onside. Barbarez, the cross in, hit away by Montillon. It's out Samoa. Head up, surveying his options. Plays it on the ground to Varela. Varela, upended, no call. Pounds the turf in disgust. Uruguay in his first season with Schalke. Uruguay's World Cup squad. Outside the left foot ball to Barbarez. It was just touched by Montillon. One ball the other way. Varela needs to control it. The back heel, Uchvalusi trips him up. And Uchvalusi could be in some trouble. He is. Look at this sweet move by Varela. Look how he sells it. Boom. Where you at? And obviously Uchvalusi with the cynical foul. Either the man or the ball, never both. And Uchvalusi, it's the first yellow card for Hamburg in the contest. And for Uchvalusi, that's his 5th yellow. So he, along with Varela, will miss the next match. Round 26 next weekend. Sven Vermont and Jörg Buma standing over this free kick. Be the end swinger. Headed away just outside the 6. Free kick hit by Sven Vermont. Asamoah has to go back to his goalkeeper. Rose playing as a sweeper. Gets it away. And as far as Hollerback. Got it down by Maltreet. Uchvalusi lets it run to Pekinok. inside the final 15 minutes of the half. Hamburg took the lead thanks to Bernardo Romeo's ninth lead goal. It all started when Maltreets was fouled by Sven Kamensch inside the center circle. Cardoso played a great ensuing free kick that was flicked on by Barber as to Romeo. Romeo beat Baldock and slipped it inside the far post. The lone goal of the contest thus far. Hamburg with a win would leapfrog Schalke, who have been holding steady in fourth place for over a month now. And Samoa, good header. Good ball. The volley! Well, lost his footing as he hit it. Have two goals this season. Last goal came in the first match after the winter break in a 2-1 draw over Wolfsburg. Abassan with a great little header. Poulsen trying to get to this 50-50 ball. He went sliding down with Hollerbach. Poulsen teases Piekenhagen off his line. Stretches. But pull it in. Played by Piekenhagen. 21-year-old netminder. Maltreets. He's a solid player. On the ground. Romeo trying to take that touch with him. Matajan trying to bang it off Manavikia. And the throw in. Poulsen called for the foul finally on Hollerbach. There's a little extra on Hollerbach after the whistle. Roast on the ready. Cardoso doesn't get over the head of Van Hoogdalem. Vika touched it forward, hoping for Barbarez to make a run. They both look at each other to indicate they got their signals crossed. Benjamin got into a forward position and he's tripped up by Sven Kamensch, who claims he was fouled first with the Namibian midfielder. Over at Manavikia. Good ball! Loose! The header by Barbarez! To Frank Rose, who was charging toward the post. That's Samoa. Strong tree trunk legs, able to absorb that tackle. Morganoff saw that play. Keep an eye on everything. Teams going in after the whistle, after the ball's away. A very physical encounter. Schalke bears Hamburg 3-0. Back in round 8. It down. And a sign he was held on to by Hoogma. No doubt about this one. Late whistle. Bayern Munich showing no mercy.
No Balak, no problem. Two goals up on Balcom. Elber getting the second goal for Bayern. Dortmund at home against Hanover. Getting a goal from Thorsten Frings. Dortmund beat Lokomotiv Moscow in the midweek in the Champions League. Need to beat AC Milan on Tuesday and hope Real Madrid fall to Lokomotiv to advance on the Champions League. Minute 39, Schalke trying to level the score. Buma takes a touch. Blocked by Hoogma. Anavikia able to stay strong enough to win throw-in. Here's that last goal-scoring opportunity for Hamburg. Look at Barbarez. Frank Rose sliding over, shuffling those feet. Did cross him right there. Not the best technique, but got away with it. Goalkeeper should never cross their feet like that. A mistake in fundamentals, certainly that Rose can get away with at his level. 40th minute. Hamburg getting only their 30th goal of the season. That's the fewest in the top eight. They've made their goals count, and they're hoping this one stands up as well, at least through the first half. Should be a corner kick. This is one of the worst calls of the season, unless Barbarez is being called for a foul. Oh my goodness. Valdok clearly won the header. Barbarez has a right to question authority there. Chase. Romeo has the goalkeeper cut off. That's good defending by Romeo, the goal scorer. Elbert not getting credited on that second goal for Bayern Munich. Ryan van Dijnhoven. Credited with the Eigentor, the own goal. Still two goals up for Bayern nonetheless. And now Mimin Scholl as well. And Jeremies was battling the injury bug as well. Everyone in the league have pretty much conceded. It's Bayern's title. Barbarez. It bounces in the back. To Rose. He picks it up. Ball not making just his sixth appearance. Had a tough World Cup and got injured preseason training and just now getting back into the mix. close out a score for Kansas, and it gets Kotbos in that huge six-pointer. At the bottom, that's where the intrigue is right now in the Bundesliga. Two places, a race for European spots. Like in this match, a race to avoid relegation. Down at the bottom. Has just scored for Kotla, so 1-1. Just like that. Inside the final 90 seconds before stoppage time. Renato Romeo has the only goal of the match. And right at the half hour mark. Hamburg trying to stretch their unbeaten run to 10 at the AOL. That one will work from Jakobsen. Pulls it. Really gave it away. In Vermont. Hold up. Licked on. Didn't have enough to get out of play. It won't. Jakobsen has to play it in front of Varela. Out and then back in, throwing for Schalke. The stoppage time. Vermont on Samoa. First time cross. Pekinaga stays on his line. Varela trying to time it. Hollerback was there. Benjamin, that's a good clearance. Into the other half. Hamburg get out of the back. Pulls it. Complete the pass. Hamburg on his second season in charge. One of two Austrian coaches. Peter Bacolt fired by 1860. Of course, we'll see them with Stuttgart tomorrow in our live match here on Fox Sports World. Romeo trying to sneak in behind Waldorf like he did for the match's only goal. Cut off by Rost. Into the second man at stoppage time. Bringing off, draws to midfield. Glancing at his watch. Second man, stoppage time nearly complete. Hamburg fans, though, have seen enough for the first half. Looking also, long look at his watch. This will be the final sequence. Matajan bounces it in. Which for Lucy, got a foot to it. And that'll do it for half number one at the AOL. Hamburg have the lead thanks to Bernardo Romeo's ninth league goal. 1-0 over Schalke. I'll be back with the halftime happenings after the break. You're watching the Bundesliga on Fox Sports World. We get set for the second half kickoff. From the AOL in Hamburg, where the home team hasn't lost in 9 straight. And Mr. Osauer getting down to the priorities, getting his cigar ready for the second half. Sunday's matches in the Bundesliga. Nuremberg trying to avoid relegation. The new coach taking over for the Fire, Peter Bacolt, hosting Stuttgart, who have an eye on the second spot in the league. Round 26. Speaking of Gertz, he'll take his men on the road for the first time against Schalke next weekend. Hamburg at the bottom. Bamberg have only led at half three times this season. They won the previous two matches. They have a one-goal lead here against the Schalke side. That's winless their last two away from the arena. Jürgen Osser, our referee, handed out two yells in the first half, and he gets half number two underway. Schalke and the ball first going right to left. They've only been beaten four times this season in the Bundesliga. 11 draws, that's the most. Very difficult team to actually get all 3 points from. Asamoah holds himself. Schalke out of the gates. Do they get a corner? They don't. A foul the other way. Asamoah, long look to the assistant referee who gives him a warning. Let's see here, Uchfalusi. Boy, that's a nickel dimer. Schalke, as I mentioned, so tough to beat. Hamburg have drawn 7 of their last 14 league matches. Schalke have some work to do, just one win to go along with 4 draws and 3 losses, and allowing the first goal. He's been excitable at times, and Jürgen Ost trying to calm him down. Who, me? Oh, I didn't say anything. You must be mistaken. 32-year-old Sven Kmet should know better, playing in his 18th match of the season. Cardoso skimmed on by Barber as Romel. Oh, he had a chance for a second goal. Cleared away. Good defensive play by Schalke. Great ball by Cardoso. Look at this little flick by Barbarez. Romeo kind of half-heartedly went for the goal. Just tried to touch it home. Frank Rose trying to fire up the troops. Getting ready to defend this corner. The first of the second half. Minute 48. The header. Marcel Maltrix got to the end of the Cardoso corner. Hamburg, 7 shutouts this season. 6 wins and a draw when keeping a clean sheet. As they're working on one now. Schalke have only been shut out 4 times all season long. As I mentioned at the top of the broadcast, these two teams in excellent form. Hamburg, 1 defeat in the last 14. Schalke, 1 defeat in the last 12. Each club have only lost once in the new year. Side footed away. Varela. Person calling for the ball. The big switch. It doesn't come. Buma. Outside of left foot ball looking for Varela. Cleared away. Big bounce. Valdo. Schalke playing this match without Emil Impenza, Andy Moeller. Nils Ode Kampus, who picked up an ankle injury against Bielefeld, has undergone surgery already. Nico van Kerkhoven missing. Tomas Heito and Victor Agali suspended. It's the same Schalke stretched to their limits. Nico Kovac, Robert's older brother. Getting a third goal as Bayern. Keep on keeping on. And Bielefeld have doubled their lead over Gladbach. Mamadou Diabang getting the goal for Bielefeld to double their advantage at home. Hamburg trying to do the same. Cardoso, that one curling late. Nodded back. Over the end line for a goal kick. Cardoso had the hand in the first goal, his free kick. bit by the barber as Flick that found Romeo, who touched home the match's only goal. 29th minute. Barberez, Valdok stumbling. Barberez head up. He's got Matavicchia. Smothered against the post and across the line. I mean, Greg Rose kept it up. And again, there should be goal, judges. How difficult would it be to have a guy in the booth to monitor these situations to make sure that a goal is not a goal? In this case, it isn't. We saw Hertha Berlin denying a goal just as close a few weeks back. The replay showed it should have stood. Meanwhile, the ensuing corner hauled in by Rost. Making some room for his punt. Gets off a beauty. Bounces it right in front of Varela. It should be a foul all over the back. Tell you what, Paulsen lobbing, Matayan jumping in as well. We've digressed for a moment. How is this not a foul? What's the Uruguayan got to do to get a foul? Let's see if there was something after the fact on Hollerback. Let's see when he gets up. Look at him. Yeah, right there. You saw it on the right leg. That's uncalled for. Rios, our referee from Cologne, trying to put the lid back on this one. And everyone saw that one. Except for the referees, Hollerback. Now escaping punishment. Frank Neubarth. Some good news this week as Schalke have made a massive step toward their attempts to close the financial gap between themselves and Bayern Munich and Dortmund. They now have agreed to an 85 million euros investment deal. The money, the bulk of it will be used to upgrade Schalke's training facilities, but some of it will also be in the coffers to sign new players. Investor Steven Schechter, who's also masterminded so-called securitization deals with English sides Newcastle, Leeds, and Leicester, helped the Royal Blues to secure that huge chunk of money. They go along with their brand new arena offside. Buma wanted the ball much earlier. To be careful yelling at his own players, we saw. Jens Lehmann getting in trouble. Pass allows the defender, as you can see. Yelling at Amon, also his own teammate with Dortmund. A couple weeks back. Line pass toward the corner flag. Jakobsen did well to jump into the attack going forward. Wins the throw in. Crowd getting anxious. Cardoso can't win it. What's the foul? Two cents in on that incident with Hollerback and Varela. Kept talking and he goes into the books. For Poulsen, his sixth yellow on the season, just got back from suspension. So Schalke players racked up some yellows this season. Only 10 minutes into the second half, Rose has it in his hands. Another good punt. Benjamin called for the foul. A pretty subdued match. Quickly take it. Matillon. Handball. No call, I tell you what. Sven Kamesh. Jürgen Oss was ready to pull the trigger. As if he had a six-piece in his holster, he had his hand in his back pocket. Great restart. And instead of going for goal, the cross came in. Let's see if Maltreats handled it. I tell you what, he did chicken wing it pretty good. That right arm. Watch Maltreats. He certainly was turning. That may have given him the benefit of the doubt. And the fourth official has asked to talk to Jürgen Oss. He's going to ask the fourth official to jot down some things for the post-match report. Well, that's a tough one because that right arm certainly headed toward the ball. Treats might have sold it by turning. He's back toward the ball carrying. The second half has been disjointed. Emotions being the best of everyone. Buma, Pekenhagen, only as far as Sand. The volley back in! Oh, ho, ho! One all! It was actually Nico Van Hoogdalem who hit the volley. And maybe the ball never lies after they're called for a penalty. Go unheard. Van Hoogdalem whips it in and it just beats Pekenhagen, who thought he saw it. A couple of players from Hamburg had a chance to touch it, but it eludes them all. And it gets past Pekenhagen. It looked like he had a clear angle to see the Van Hoogdalem shot. But instead, Van Hoogdalem gets his first league goal. And we're tied at a goal apiece. Schalke side showing how difficult they really are to beat. Scratching out a goal, it wasn't pretty. Didn't have to be. Cardoso called for the foul, whacks the ball away as well. Schalke fans have made the trip east from Gelsenkirchen, needing to warm up the voices. Looks like Nahito Takahata will get a chance to run out here. The club has made a substitution yet. Exchange of headers. Poulsen settles it down. Playing right back in this match. Varela, Baldock, Barbarez sliding, only helps out Schalke's cause. Here comes Schalke. And here comes the first substitution of the contest. Right at the hour mark. Looks like they're going to hold off on the substitution. Buma. Last corner. Schalke cashed in. Buma. Oh, what a touch! Buma! He leaves it! was sweet stuff from Boomer. First check of the out-of-town scoreboard in the second half. Bielefeld getting a goal for Wichnerek. 3-0 over Gladbach. That could be a huge win for Bielefeld. At halftime, Bernard Romeo's ninth league goal, minute 29. Barber has fouled as he got forward. Finally, we'll get a substitution. Schalke getting the time call from Marco van Hoogelum just a couple minutes ago. A goal apiece. Mahino Takahata will check in. He'll get a half hour. He'll replace Cardoso. Let's see how they rejig the lineup. Of striker, Cardoso, a midfielder. And Cardoso comes off for the 11th time this season. Oh, what a cutie. What a cutie. So Takahata's in. One goal this season, of course, that came against Bayern Munich. The only goal Bayern Munich have given up in, I don't know, it seems like 6 months. Quite that long, but Takahata got the goal to save a point on the road. And that's right here on FSW in round 20. Schalke have yet to make a substitution. I wouldn't expect them to go too deep into their bench for this one. With so many players out. Takahata off his chest. Touch, one to forget. Takahara used to being a strange man in a foreign land. He had an unsuccessful loan stint with Boca Juniors in Argentina. Samoa held off by Hollerback. Hassan was there as well, but Hamburg had the throw-in. Takahara did nothing that six-month loan spell with the Argentine Giants, but he's improved his game. Japanese football of the year. 27 goals in 26 matches for Jubilo Iwata in 2002 as Iwata won both stages of the J-League. First time that's ever happened. Minute 63. Dane Startlet. Poulsen forward. Flicked on by Barella. Piekenhagen has it in his hands. Schalke came in his match unbeaten in the last four on the heels of three straight draws. And what do you know? Tie at a goal apiece here. He's been quiet. He'll take his corner. Shot the goal scorer. Marco van Hoogelum there defensively. And it back toward Medvedev. Marmarez has been calling for a corner kick all match long. He doesn't get it again. Bosnian. Stuck on five goals for a month now. Hugma. Hugma battling with Barella. Poulsen at Samoa. Samoa. Hollerback. He's finally going to get the yellow. It's only a matter of time. So Hollerback picks up his 10th yellow card of the season. And he'll sit out the next match. So Hamburg will go without Hollerbach and Uchfalusi. Their encounter at Mönchengladbach next week. Takahata trying to get the foul. Jürgen Oss waves a defiant finger at him, telling him to get up. Good touch by Barella. Here's a good run. Chest it down. Sven Kamesh timed his run perfectly again. Great ball. The touch let him down right there. Well, it wasn't too bad, but he forced only one option. That was a left-footed shot. Takahara to Barbarets. Over the top of the defense to Romeo. Romeo cut off. Headed to Rose from Matian. That's nicely handled by the Argentine. From a Boca player himself. More Argentines beginning to find their way to the Bundesliga, only adding to the league's credibility worldwide and the overall quality and talent. Romeo. Cardoso just came off. Matian for Schalke. Jakobsen, he was pushed. Give me a throw in. Puma has a long throw. Keeps it short. Good skills. Barbarets. Great hold. Malavicchia slows it up. That was a dangerous play. Matian got that foot up there. Johan Miku, I've just been told, has received a red card for Bremen. We're taking on Rostock at the Weserstadion. Second red card for Miku this season. Jakobsen. Done better with that. Puma allowed to get in there. Some of the Schalke fans filled up their section of the AOL. World Cup. Hamburg also the front runner to get Germany's Olympic bid. As countries begin to get their bids in order. Puma's on the field for the 2012 Olympics. Side. Great ball, Matavicki off his chest. He's met by Matian. The takeover, Barbarets. Barbarets keeps it. Going to go, but to Jakobsen. Now Matavicki. Barbarets, full sign ball out to Benjamin. He wants to cross it in. He does. Right on top of Rost. Rost makes the grab right in front of the 6-yard box. He rolls it out. Starts the attack the other way. Poulsen. That's Valdok in support. Plays it forward. Chested down. Here's a chance for Schalke. Into the space. Hoogma off his head. Piekenhagen off his line. And he outwits Emerson. It certainly helps when you can use your hands. The match opening up a bit. Scores. Leverkusen Carsten Ramelow getting a rare goal at home in the Bayer Arena, Leighton Wolfsburg. As Horster trying to resurrect the Leverkusen ship for the second time since taking over. Boomer claiming he didn't commit the foul, washing his hands of the incident. Benjamin has earned a free kick in a good spot, and this means Mehdi Manavikia time. His 11 assists, tops in the Bundesliga. Sweet move by Benjamin, getting past Matajan, and then, ouch. Look at Boomer here. Manavikia roasts, punches away. Benjamin pops it up in the air. Uchfalusi, he wins it. Advantage played. For a moment, finally get a whistle to bring it back. Poulsen already has a yellow card. Poulsen already has a yellow, and that is it. Red card to Danish midfielder Christian Poulsen. In minute 71, and he has some parting shots. So Poulsen, just back from suspension, missed the match against Bielefeld last week. Will miss the match next week against 1860. Poulsen leaning in with that forearm elbow. Didn't hesitate. The ensuing free kick. Oh, Tomas Uchfalusi. Didn't score a goal in the Bundesliga until earlier this season. Has two now, and that was a great chance for a third. Great ball by Matavikia. Uchfalusi. Kind of pulled the string there with the header. Substitution of the match for either club so far. At least he got a goal before his first yellow card in the Bundesliga. Varela gets the corner. Uchfalusi blocks it out of play for a corner kick. Still alive. Look at this. Benjamin gets a foot to it. This is a Schalke side that's been in fourth place for four straight weeks. But when you look at the results, they only have two really good wins all season long. They beat Stuttgart 2-0 back in round 21. And then the victory over Hamburg back in round 8. The rest, just victories and draws against also-rans. They've struggled against Dortmund and Bayern. tie Dortmund to two draws this season. And they drew 0-0 with Bayern Munich as well. Minute 75, Brent Roche involved in another tight contest. Lucy wins the first ball. On the ground, Romeo can't hold on to it. He's been quiet for getting the goal. He'll open the scoring back at minute 29. Hoogma touches it to Piekenhagen. Falusi touches it back to Piekenhagen. Signing moment. Hamburg defensively able to recover. Barberez, the flick. Dimitri Romeo. Season so far, coming in this round, been 216 matches in the Bundesliga. 41 of them have been scoring draws, 14 goalless draws. 99 times the home team has won, 62 times the away team has won. Rostock getting a goal for Dietmar Hirsch. Leading 10-man Bremen, Johan Miku sent off in that one. And Leandro, little used, has added a second for Dortmund. After Torsten Frings opened the scoring. Peter Van Hoot has pulled the goal back for Gladbach, 3-1 now. And Kaiserslautern have gotten a goal from Marion Ristoff. Battling injury the last 3 years. 2-1 for Kaiserslautern on the roll at Kotbos. Kaiserslautern trying to extend their unbeaten run to 7 matches. As they thrashed Nuremberg 5-0 right here on FSW last week. Here's a chance. Varela, no worse for wear, had it poked away from Luke Falusi. Hoogman not happy with Varela, who was down for a long time. stretchered off and came back on and nearly ran on to a goal scoring opportunity. Buma making sure the footing is just right. Minute 80. The goal kick. Eric Meyer will come on. Next opportunity. Good tackle by Montillon on Jakobsen. Benjamin comes off one of his better matches. He's replaced by Meyer, who can try to get a goal. Meyer making his 14th appearance, 10 off the bench. That's the most on the club. Has 3 goals and an assist, but he hasn't scored since the first match after the winter break. And the second goal on a 2-2 draw with Hanover. Anyone's match for the taking. But right now, a point apiece, the safe bet, Takahata. And Samoa. And Samoa called for the foul. There was a hint of a handball in there. Trying to sort out the marking. Minute 82, Matavicchia. Rowe stays at home. Barberez went up. Didn't make contact before coming back down. Look at Matavicchia's free kick. Tomislav Meric has tied the score for Wolfsburg at Leverkusen. Tomas Hurster had said that if he were to fall to Wolfsburg, he may not be in charge of Leverkusen for another match. It's a good feeling that Horster had enjoyed the first two matches in charge. Came to an end as Leverkusen fell twice to Bayern Munich in the Pokal semis and in the Bundesliga last week. Meyer kept it in near the penalty spot. Out of reach of Barber as he looks tired. Varela thought about playing it long. Hollerback knocks him off the ball. Play on. Minute 83. Good win by Meyer. Romeo. Barberez. Great flick. Romeo. Cut off by Volnok. Christian Lischies has been sent off for Bremen. We're down to 9 men. Matavicchia. Oh, a foul off the ball. The cross in. And a blatant elbow to the face. The assistant referee saw it. And the red card to Montillon. 9-man Schalke now trying to hang on here at the AOL against Hamburg. Folks, that's Annabelle Montillon's first card of the season in 17 appearances. There it is right here. Watch the middle of your screen. Right there, off the ball. The assistant referee flag up right away. The Venice was played. But Montillon didn't need to do that. So after Poulsen received his second yellow card of the match earlier in this half in minute 71, a little over 10 minutes later, Montillon sent off, and he's not leaving in a timely manner. This could be more than a one-game suspension. Fourth yellow card of the season for Schalke. 85th minute, just 9 men for the visitors. Hamburg now, no, the pressure's on them. The final 5 to get the result. And Jurgenos stops his watch because Matian took his time, his sweet time in leaving. The header. Stretch your lead to 4-1 over Gladbach. Mamadou Diabang, a hat trick. Gladbach, they're going to suffer another defeat. Let's see what happens here. A wild match. Ronaldo Romeo opened the score in minute 29. Marco van Hoogelum leveled the score with an opportunistic volley. Jakobsen deflected. What a touch by Barbarets. Cross, 2-1, guess who? Takahara.
Point lead at the top.
Seignolle just signed a two-year contract extension this week. She rewards the club with a goal. Rafael Vicky gonna come on. He'll get to share the win bonus should they hang on here. Brent Rose, he's made the run up. Been a long time since we've seen this in the Bundesliga. Last chance saloon just about for the visitors. I'll tell you what, Takahar wins it. An empty goal. Romero into the space. Does he hit it early? He does. Rolling home. Romero's second goal. 3-1 Hamburg. The Poulsen and Matian turn the tide. Takahara adding a second, which right now is a game winner. His first home goal for Hamburg and Romeo. Getting his fifth two-goal performance of the season in all competitions. It's fourth in the Bundesliga. Buma picks up the yellow. He's done playing. He just wants to go home at this point. Sixth yellow card for Buma. That's what Buma said after the...
Ladies, if you're tired of embarrassing hair stubble or getting nicks and cuts...